Hey, hello. Hello, everybody. This is Mark Carlin, the results hypnotist. And once again, I am giving you some more information to help you to stop smoking. Yesterday, well, for the past 15, maybe 16 days, I've been doing these live Facebook live recordings. Go ahead, like, comment, share, help other people as well as yourself. To get the tools that will help you become that non-smoker. Now, yesterday I started to go over the reasons that people give as to why they quit smoking or want to quit smoking. And this is a continuation of that because there were really so many, I didn't get a chance to go through them all. So I've got my notes and I'm going to go over these with you. This is to help give you some ideas of how you can use these thoughts about why it's important to quit smoking to help motivate you and to also give you an idea of what to think about during your quit whenever you get that idea that, oh, you know what, I'd like to have a cigarette. Oh, you know what, there's some guy smoking. I think I want a cigarette, or I'm missing cigarettes. I'm missing smoking. Whatever that nonsensical chatter is going on in your mind, these reasons will give you ammunition to keep you on track. And the best way to use these is to connect to the message on an emotional basis. Connect to the message on an emotional basis. I'm a little bit suffering with some allergies. If you might know what an allergy symptom is, this is a little bit of an allergy going on. So here, to begin with, here are some of those reasons. Elizabeth says her husband left her on an uphill hike because she couldn't breathe and she's just literally tired of it. When you start to feel that, oh, I'm so fed up, I'm so tired, I've had enough of this, you're at a very good place to have a much better quit. And you can use those memories connected to that emotional to help you to stay on track. Very important. Getting the emotions involved in your quit is very important. Just think about this. Your emotions are driving the show to get you to continue to smoke. Why shouldn't you allow your emotions to drive the show to help you to quit? Here's another one. Terry says, the price of cigarettes was a big factor. I also hated the smell of cigarettes. Well, you know, the price of cigarettes is very expensive. A lot of people smoke about a pack a day, some, you know, a half a pack to a pack. I had somebody even on this, on some of these questions and answers, who'd smoke two packs a day. In New York City, where I am, and I work with people to help them stop smoking, cigarettes are now $15 a pack. $15 a pack. If you're smoking a pack a day, that comes out to about $5,500 a year. It's almost $475 a month that you are spending on your ill health or your future ill health, or you're spending this to do something you really don't want to do any longer. Okay, think about that. Big things to concern yourself with. Kate said she hates the smell and the taste. You hate the smell and the taste. Oh boy, I remember when I was younger and I was smoking, cigarette commercials were allowed on TV. And I remember they used to have a commercial about coming up to the taste. It was like some kind of a wonderful taste of cigarettes. There's no wonderful taste of cigarettes. There never was. It's all in your mind. And these cigarette companies were looking to develop in you the thought that it was tasteful, that it did taste good. It never tasted good. When you started to smoke, your body physically rejected it. And it didn't taste good then. It doesn't taste good now. You just become so used to the taste that you kind of ignore it. That's what really happens. Don't get sucked in. to the nonsense. Monique says the reasons why she wants to quit or she's quitting is because of her cough, her son, and it's just embarrassing. You know, in this day and age, that's something we didn't have when I was smoking. The embarrassment factor. Smoking was almost like a badge of honor. You know, like you were cool. And you know what? It still is. When you're young, you think you're cool. But when you get to a point where nobody else is smoking or they're pushing you out the door and they want to just get rid of you and you see the offensive faces that people are making when you're around them because you smell of cigarette smoke, it's really embarrassing. Keely says the cough is the worst and she can't believe how embarrassed she is. Even when she starts coughing, when she's around people, how embarrassed that makes her. And she always said she had something in her throat or something. She was making up excuses as to why she was coughing because she didn't want to admit that she was smoking. And she was actively taking a role in causing her own embarrassment. That was even more embarrassing for her, I'll bet. And Kelly agrees. She agrees. It's totally embarrassing. Kevin says, my constant coughing and the pain when I was trying to breathe. Imagine that painful breathing. I know exactly what that feels like. When I get this allergy thing, it's painful for me to breathe. It's hard to breathe. And I don't smoke. I haven't smoked for decades. Stacy says her husband was put in a hospital with very, very, very high blood pressure. And they kept him there for a week. She stayed with him almost the entire time. And they told him that he had to quit. And since they both had been without cigarettes for a week, they decided that it was time and that she'd been wanting to quit for a while. She got tired of the wheezing at night. She was out of breath and she was also embarrassed about and it was very inconvenient, not to mention that it was expensive. So she's got a lot of personal reasons. Remember, those personal reasons are important to help keep you an active non-smoker, a continuous non-smoker when you decide to do that quit. Tammy says, I can't walk a block without feeling out of breath, and it controls my life, and it costs too damn much. No truer words. Lisa says, my grandson, just knowing that her grandson is around, and she doesn't want to smoke in front of him, and she's not getting any younger. She's now 45 days smoke-free. Anna says she's planning to have another baby. You know, you smoke when you have a baby. It's like your baby is smoking. Your baby, it cuts off oxygen to your baby's development. That's why I think that they say that that's why a lot of women have preemies or not fully developed babies. Something you don't want. Rayanne says, besides my health, I've been spending on smoking more than eating. She says she can stay without food, but not without cigarettes. How sad is that? That you give up food in order to eat. I mean, you give up food in order to smoke. Crazy, crazy. Sharon says, my beautiful grandchildren, one of them said to me, please give up smoking because I don't want you to die. And now she knows she found out she has COPD. And her poor granddaughter got so upset, she decided that she'd get some help and she would quit. Rose has colitis. She ends up in the hospital for 3 days and couldn't smoke and decided, oh, heck, it's now time. It's now or never. And she's successfully been finished with cigarettes for 60 days, 2 months now. Kristen says she wanted to save her health and her finances. The double barrel, huh? Nice. Eddie says the cost, damn near $9 a pack. And he was buying two packs a day. $18 a day, even more than it will cost for a pack of cigarettes in New York. Stephanie says she has vein issues and she's diabetic. The doctor said she'd lose her left foot. Lose your left foot because you want to continue to smoke. She's now over a year smoke-free and she's down 25 pounds. You know, a lot of people question whether they're going to gain weight when they stop smoking. And here's Stephanie, who quit smoking for a year and she lost 25 pounds. It's all up to you. It's all up to you what you want to do. You want to lose or you want to gain. That's it. Nicotine is a stimulant. There is a tiny bit of an increased metabolism because it's a stimulant. So when you lose that stimulant, the metabolism might slow down a little bit. That's easily countered by just doing a little bit more activities, walking a little bit more, doing a little bit of exercise, breathing a little bit better, more breath work. These are simple techniques to increase your metabolism. That's it. Very simple. And that's it. Stephanie wants to dance at her grandbaby's weddings. Well, there's plenty more, folks. My name is Mark Carlin. I'm the results hypnotist. Give me a call, 212-223-1832. I can set you up. I can give you a strategy session for free right now. We could talk about what your options are, how you can do this on your own. If you'd like my help, I'm there for you as well. Professional help. I have over 20 years experience helping people to stop smoking. It's one of the easiest ways that you will find that you can quit. I got an email just today from Niall, one of my clients, and I asked him how he was doing. His email was, "I forgot what I came to you for." Isn't that beautiful? How would you like to forget what you were doing and that was causing all this difficulties? Nice, huh? 212-223-1832. Thanks for coming here. Thanks for listening, watching. Like, ring the bell to subscribe. Find this on Facebook, on YouTube. Share the love. Take care. Appreciate it. Have a great night.